गुड आफ्टरनून टू गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल माय स्टूडेंट एंड व्यूअर्स. जस्ट कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ लास्ट डिसीज इन यस्टरडे कवर्ड डिसीज कॉज्ड बाय बैक्टीरिया. नेम ऑफ द डिसीज इज अ टाइफाइड. लास्ट वन ऑफ द क्वेश्चन आई वांट टू इंटरेक्ट विथ यू. नेम द कन्फर्मेटरी टेस्ट दैट इज यूज्ड इन अ डिटेक्शन ऑफ अ टाइफाइड फीवर. नेम द कन्फर्मेटरी टेस्ट ड्यूरिंग स्टडी ऑफ ईच डिसीज. सम इंपॉर्टेंट स्टेप्स आर यूज्ड. वन ऑफ द स्टेप इज कॉल्ड एज अ डायग्नोसिस. One of the step is called a diagnosis. Name the test that is used in the detection of typhoid. Yes, Abhishek, Baswa Pragna. The next other student. Name the test used in a detection of typhoid fever. The test is called a Vidal. In other way, it is called as Vidal test. Vidal or Vidal test is used in the detection of typhoid. The next, immediately diagnosis is followed by last step is treatment. Different types of antibiotics produced by different pharmaceutical industries. Such kind of antibiotics prescribed by the doctor and such antibiotics are used in the treatment of typhoid. Then next step, different types of antibiotics, it is depending upon the doctor. Different, for example, you will take that here, different types of industry, pharmaceutical industry, they produces a different kinds of antibiotics. It is depends upon the doctor. Different doctors prescribed or prescribes different types of antibiotics, and such kinds of antibiotics are used in the treatment of which disease here, typhoid. When a report came from the laboratory, the report is positive or negative? Positive. Means presence of which germs in the body sample? Presence of typhoid germs present in the body sample. Which body sample is isolated from the patient? Means blood. Next step, a classical example to the medical field. Classical example to the medical field. Classical example or classical case. Classical case, best example or best, classical case to the medical field. Medical field. Name of the lady is Mary Mellon. Mary Mellon, she belongs to USA, United States. Mary Mellon is a best example to the medical field. Means a classical case example to the medical field. Medical field. Her name is Mary Mellon, belonging to United States. She is typhoid germs. Is referred as a healthy carrier. She never shows first symptoms. But typhoid germs are in her body. She is suffering from the typhoid. Who never suffering from typhoid? Name of the lady is Mary Mellon. She belongs to USA. Never she suffering, but she carries typhoid germs in her body. Referred as healthy carrier. Healthy carrier. Her nickname is, her nickname is Typhoid Mary. Typhoid Mary. She carries the typhoid germs, hence her nickname is Typhoid Mary. Then next, professionally she is cooker. Professionally she is cooker. She prepared the food and food is served to the number of people. She appointed, for example, one of the reputed family in USA appointed as a cooker. Who is appointed as a cooker? Typhoid Mary appointed as a cooker. So whatever food is prepared by Mary Mellon and supplied to or served to the family member during her profession, then totally how many cases the disease is spread? The disease is spreaded from the Mary Mellon, okay, to remaining member. So how many cases in her profession means 1300 cases. But when a case becomes a serious, here total number of family members are 11. Out of 11 family members, 6 members suffering from the typhoid disease. Sir, how 6, okay, here out of 11 members, how they 6 members suffering from the typhoid disease means whatever the food is prepared by Mary Mellon and such a food is served to family member, okay, through the food these germs are entered in the family members of so hence these peoples are suffering from the which disease here? Typhoid. She is carrier. Who is a carrier? Typhoid Mary or Mary Mellon is a carrier. Okay, carrier of a which germs here? Typhoid germs, but never she suffer from the disease. Yes, this is the last step related to the typhoid disease. Then I want to remind you, in yesterday few here factors or ways are studied. These ways are help in controlling the diseases. These ways are help in achieving the good health condition. First way is balanced diet, regular exercise, yoga, meditation. All these are the practices, including personal hygiene. That is also one of the way or factor that help in achieving good health condition. Along with other than these ways, have any idea about the other than these, they are also help in maintaining the good health condition. Next is Awareness of disease is also helpful in achieving good health condition. Then next way it's also help in achieving a good health condition. Proper disposal of waste, it is also one more way that help in achieving a good health condition. Then next, proper maintenance, which maintenance? Sanitary, individual sanitary or maybe sanitary, okay, necessary to maintain cleanliness in individual sanitary or public areas. These are the few, okay, they are helping achieving a good condition. The next, second bacterial disease in a human being is, name of the disease is called pneumonia. Is a second bacterial disease in human being. Sir, causative agent, already we know that here bacteria is a causative agent. Among the bacteria, which bacteria causes a pneumonia? स्ट्रेप्टोकॉकस निमोनिए, स्ट्रेप्टोकॉकस निमोनिए, स्ट्रेप्टोकॉकस निमोनिए, निमोनिए इज ए कॉजिटिव एजेंट ऑफ निमोनिया, आर इंस्टेड ऑफ स्ट्रेप्टोकॉकस इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड डिप्लोकॉकस निमोनिए, डिप्लोकॉकस निमोनिए और स्ट्रेप्टोकॉकस निमोनिए इज ए बिग कॉजेटिव एजेंट ऑफ टाइफाइड डिसीज. नेक्स्ट इट इज ऑल्सो कॉज्ड हियर विच इज निमोनिया इज ऑल्सो कॉज्ड बाय वन मोर पैथोजन, नेम ऑफ द पैथोजन इज वायरस. That the name of the virus is Haemophilus influenzae. Haemophilus influenzae is a virus. This virus also causes a disease. Name of the disease is called pneumonia. Third step during study of each disease is a mode of infection or instead of infection you'll use the alternative term mode of transmission. How this disease is transmitted? Which disease? Pneumonia. This disease is transmitted from infected person to healthy person through the droplets or aerosols released from the infected throat during either maybe sneezing or coughing. Droplets released from the infected person, such droplets are released into the air or atmosphere. Such droplets means which containing air, which pneumonia causing air. Germs are present in the droplets. Such droplets are inhaled by, such air is inhaled by which person air? Such a air is inhaled by healthy person and through this air the germs reach to the respiratory tract. Then next, from infected person to the healthy person, along with this way, one more way is there. For example, some of the objects used by a person, he is suffering from the pneumonia. Such objects are referred as a infected. The infected object may be keyboard, or infected object may be pen, or infected object may be notebook, or infected object may be utensils. Through these infected objects, the pathogen enters in the respiratory tract of which person? Healthy person. And in healthy person also start to symptoms after incubation period. Then next, mode of transmission or mode of infection is finished. Then next step here, sign and symptoms. Sir, which are the sign and symptoms appears in the patient? He is suffering from a pneumonia. First, here, headache, than a headache, and there is a shortness in a breathing, shortness in a breathing, shortness in breathing. Who suffering from the pneumonia, difficulties in a breathing, that is referred as a shortness in a breathing. Then next he is feeling as a feeling, okay, as a weakness. Then along with there is a cough. Then slight fever. Main symptom is a fever. Along with fever there is a chills. Chills means shaking. Due to that increase the body temperature, or due to fever chills will be appear. Mainly main symptoms of the which disease here, pneumonia, is a shortness in breathing, effect on breathing. Then fevers, okay, due to the presence of a germs in his or her body, and it is followed by there is a chills. These are the few. Along with these symptoms, one more, there is a headache, but in rare cases only there is a weakness. These are the few symptoms reported or observed or occurs in a patient who suffering from which disease here, pneumonia. Then next, it is followed by, then patient approaches to doctor. Then doctor prescribes, no need to make a different types of a test here. Then doctor started treatment. When patient approaches to doctor and the doctor started treatment, here also antibiotics here. Antibiotics are available in medical shops, or antibiotics are available in the markets. Such antibiotics prescribed by the doctor, especially in the treatment of pneumonia disease. One thing must be remembered here. Sir, name the affected organ. Name the affected organ in case of pneumonia. Yes? Which is the affected organ during study of typhoid? Which is the affected organ? Small intestine is the affected organ. But in this case, means in pneumonia, name the affected organ. Affected organ is the lungs. My dear student, you will remember here, pneumonia is a bacterial disease, but it is also caused by virus. But measure here, infected from bacteria. Already name of the pathogen is earlier used. Name of the pathogen is Streptococcus pneumoniae. In another way, it is also called Diplococcus pneumoniae. Streptococcus means, what is the meaning of a strepto? Strepto means, what is the meaning? And coccus, the bacteria are grouped into four categories, or four groups based on their shape. Coccus means a spherical shaped bacteria are called as a coccus. If they occur in a chain, for example, two spherical shaped bacteria are attached to each other, that is called diplococcus. Means the spherical shaped bacteria, they occur in a chain, it is called as a streptococcus. Streptococcus is a causative agent of pneumonia. Then next, which is the affected organ? I want to once again remind you, name the affected organ in pneumonia means lungs. In lungs particularly, name the structural and functional unit of lungs means alveoli are the structural and functional units of lungs, where pneumonia pathogen or pneumonia germ affected to alveoli. Alveoli are filled with the alveolis are filled with the fluid. Hence, the person who suffering from the pneumonia, he facing difficulty in particularly breathing. So, due to the infection of a streptococcus pneumonia to which organ? Lung, particularly in lung, alveoli. The alveoli, when here alveolis are affected from the pneumonia germ, and such alveolis are filled with fluid and difficulties in breathing. And one more I want to remind you here, then the case becomes a serious, in such a cases, name one more symptom appear in the patient. Have any idea? Example here, lips and a nail bed. Lips and a nail bed turns to lips in a severe condition. In severe condition, lips and a nail bed turns to there is a gray to bluish color due to scarcity of oxygen. Okay. Lips and nail bed turn to, why lips and nail bed turn to grayish to bluish color means due to the scarcity of oxygen. Namely here, it is a disease, damages to respiratory organ, particularly alveoli, and hence affected person facing a difficulty breathing. Like shortness in breathing, who suffer from one of the symptoms, shortness in breathing, the main symptom observed in a patient who suffering from the asthma. Yes. Then it is followed by next moot vidhi. You'll remember here, bacterial disease name is pneumonia. It damages to lower respiratory tract, not upper respiratory tract. Next disease is a viral disease. Before enter the viral disease, have any idea about the bacterial diseases? Name the diseases caused by bacteria other than typhoid and pneumonia in human being. Name the diseases caused by bacteria in human being other than typhoid and pneumonia. Already discussed in yesterday, typhoid disease is discussed, and today pneumonia. Have any idea about the bacterial diseases in case of human being? Are you heard the word TB? Tuberculosis. Tuberculosis is a one more bacterial disease in a human being. Name of the bacteria is Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Then next, along with TB, one more bacterial disease in human being is leprosy. Leprosy, Mycobacterium, okay, lepre. Then along with leprosy, next is a cholera. The next, anthrax. Then diphtheria, whooping cough. The next, gonorrhea, syphilis. Gonorrhea and syphilis are the sexually transmitted disease. These are the few diseases caused by bacteria in a human being. Along with this, have any idea about the tetanus? Tetanus also one more bacterial disease in a human being, that is Clostridium tetani is a causative agent other than typhoid and pneumonia. So tetanus, tuberculosis, leprosy, cholera, gonorrhea and syphilis are the other few best example to the bacterial diseases in human being. The next, it is followed by move towards the second type, means another pathogen causes diseases in a human being. That name of the pathogen is virus. How you say the definition of virus? Viruses. In simple way, the definition of virus means viruses are said to be poisonous fluids. Poisonous fluids. With the help of poisonous fluid, the disease is easily spread from one person to the another person, or one organism to another organisms, or one plant to another plant. Related to our study, only one viral disease, that name of the disease is called, common cold. Already here, you'll remember during study of each disease, you'll remember few step. That first step is name of the disease is common cold. Second step is particularly which group of virus causes a common cold. A group of rhinovirus. A group of rhinovirus causes a common cold. It is followed by third step is mode of infection or mode of transmission. How this disease is transmitted. Example, the mode of here, direct transmission from, for example, who approaches healthy person contact with infected person. Through the infected person, which causing germs? Common colding germs. Which germs here? Virus. Particularly which virus? A group of rhinovirus. These viruses are directly entered into the body of a healthy person from a infected person. When healthy person contact with a infected person. The next, in one more way means, for example, some of the objects used by infected person. Example, sir, name the objects used by the infected person. Example, here also you will take that here. Notebook is one of the object. Pen is another object. Kerchief is another object. Then keyboard is another object. Such objects used by the infected person. During using, the germs are released from the infected person, and such germs are reached to the notebook, or okay, they falls on the pen or maybe key. They are infected objects. Through the infected objects, the germs are entered in the body of a healthy person. The incubation period may be as short as 1 week or maybe 12 to 15 days. Within few days, the symptoms will be appears where in a healthy person. Which symptoms here? The next, move towards it. Next step, directly next step is symptoms. Sir, name the symptoms. They appear in a infected person who suffering from who suffering from common cold. Following are the symptoms seen in a patient. First here, nasal congestion. You'll remember, I want to remind you here, pneumonia disease infected to lower respiratory tract, but a common cold affect to upper respiratory tract only, not a lower respiratory tract. First symptom, nasal congestion and nasal congestion and discharge. During breathing, especially the infected person suffering during breathing, so due to nasal congestion, it is followed by discharge of a fluid or discharge of a mucus through the nose. Then next there is a, even though it also infected to, there is a infected to throat here, infected to throat here, there is a inflammation. Then next it is followed by changed in a voice, that is referred as hoarseness. Means the germ, common cold causing germ means virus, affected to sound box here. Then infected person facing difficulties in speaking, when damages to voice box. The next, it is followed by fever. Then along with fever, headache. These are the few symptoms commonly seen in a the patient who suffering from the common cold. The next, the symptoms will be minimum 3 days, as long as how many days means 7 days or 1 week, 3 days to 1 week, the minimum symptoms will be appear in the patient, okay, who suffering from the common cold. But here which are not ready, antibiotics are not capable to control the, which is, this is here, common cold that caused by virus. Yes. Then next, totally how many diseases are covered? 3 diseases. One of the disease, okay, caused by virus, and another 2 diseases caused by bacteria. One is typhoid and next is pneumonia. Then you'll remember here, common cold only infect to or affect to upper respiratory tract, not a lower respiratory tract. Then next step is next disease caused by another pathogen. Name of the pathogen belonging to Helminthus. You know, Helminthus In another way, they are also called as roundworms or round nematodes. Then, name the diseases caused by helminthus in a human being. Okay, and along with helminthus, another type of pathogen is protozoan. Along with protozoan, next pathogen is fungi. So first, before enter the helminthus disease study, concentrate toward the protozoan diseases. The diseases caused by the protozoans, next helminthus, and next fungi or fungi. Sir, name the diseases caused by protozoan in human being is, first disease is malaria. The two diseases, malaria is the first disease caused by protozoan, and it is followed by amoebiasis, second disease. Then, to take that here, malaria for detailed study. Malaria is the name of the disease caused by protozoan. Again, in protozoa particularly, which one causes a malaria? Example, name of the disease already over, it is followed by name of the causative agent is Plasmodium. Causative agent is a Plasmodium. In Plasmodium, different species. Sir, totally, how many different species were in a Plasmodium? There are four different types of species. First species is Plasmodium vivax. Then another species is Plasmodium ovale. Then Plasmodium falciparum. Then Plasmodium malariae. Totally, four different types of species causes a which disease? Malaria. Name the different types of Plasmodium. They causes a malaria disease means four. Plasmodium vivax, ovale, falciparum, malaria. Which species causes fatal disease? Fatal means leads to the death. Which species? Plasmodium falciparum. Neat point of view. Which Plasmodium causes a fatal disease means Plasmodium falciparum. The next move toward the, it is followed by, before enter the next step, mode of infection. Then remember that Plasmodium is a protozoan parasite. This Plasmodium is a protozoan parasite. This parasite required how many host cells? This parasite required two different type of host cell. How many different types of host cell is needed by Plasmodium to complete their life cycle? Two different types of host cells. Name the two host cells required by Plasmodium. Female Anopheles mosquito. female anopheles, female anopheles mosquito, female anopheles mosquito is a primary host cell. Second host cell is needed by plasmodium is human host cell here. Human. How? The question is asked in a NEET examination. Dash is used as a primary host cell. Plasmodium dash uses primary host cell and dash uses secondary host cell. Which is act as a primary host cell? Anopheles mosquito is act as a primary host cell. Then a human cell is act as a secondary host cell. It needed how many host cell here? 2 host cell to complete their life cycle. Yes. Then before enter the next step, concentrate toward the sir who studied about the malaria. One of the greatest scientist his name is Laveran. Laveran studied a cyst like structure. Laveran studied a cyst like structure. What is the meaning of a cyst? Cyst means a protective layer around the protozoan, that is called our protozoan or spores, called as a cyst. That is also called as a encystation. Formation during study of particularly multiple fusion in amoeba. Amoeba withdrawn its pseudopodia, and around the plasma membrane it secretes a protective layer. This protective layer protected to amoeba from adverse condition, that is called encystment. Here who observed a cyst like structure observed in the body of infected person? Who observed? Laveran. Laveran is a name of the scientist. He reported or he studied a cyst like structure present in the body of infected person. Then one more, another scientist contribution. Name of the scientist is Ronald Ross. Another scientist. Sir, what is the contribution of second scientist? He studied the complicated malarial life cycle. Who studied malarial life cycle? Ronald Ross studied malarial life cycle. So these two scientists' contribution is related to the malarial disease. Then how plasmodium uses 2 host cell to complete their life cycle? Which plasmodium causes a fatal malaria means Plasmodium falciparum. Totally how many species? 4 species. Name the 4 species of a plasmodium means Vivax, Ovale, falciparum and malaria. Next, how life cycle is started? Then let us concentrate toward the here. Infected person, from the infected person, means which one here infect or which one bites here? Healthy mosquito bites to infected person. Healthy mosquito bites to infected person. You will remember it here. Sir, name the matured infecting spores. Remember here. Sir, name the mature infecting spores present in the body of a female Anopheles mosquito means? Name the infecting spores present in the matured female Anopheles mosquito means? Name of the spores are called, name of the spores are called, there is a sporozoites. Name the infecting spores present in a infected female Anopheles mosquito means? Sporozoites. Okay, sporozoites. Sporozoites are the infective spores. Yes? Name the infective spores present in a female Anopheles mosquito. Name the infected spores present in a infected female mosquito. Sporozoite. Sir, how these sporozoites entered in the healthy person? Where sporozoites are present? Sporozoites are present in the infected, female Anopheles mosquito. Initially they are present in a intestine and move towards the salivary gland, and where they are stored, here sporozoites are here. Where they are stored means they are stored in a which gland? Salivary gland of a which mosquito? Female Anopheles mosquito. Yes, here a salivary gland contains a infecting spores named as sporozoite, and such a infected female Anopheles mosquito, bites to the which person here? Healthy person. Okay, which one bites here? Infected female Anopheles mosquito bites to which person here? Healthy person, and injected which spores here? Which spores are injected? Sporozoites entered in the body of a healthy person. Okay, healthy person becomes a infected person when sporozoites are entered through female Anopheles mosquito. Then further, so these sporozoites are ready to move towards the one of the important organ called as liver. Name the target organ of a malaria means? First, you'll remember here. One of the target organ of malarial parasite is liver, and it is followed by Liver and RBCs from which one? Malarial parasite.